Okay, welcome back to World of Final Fantasy, where we are, where we just unlocked the Crystal Tower. And let's see what awaits us here. I remember down was the path we can't go yet. It's blocked by several gimme golems and a few other things, but mostly the golems. So we go up first.
Let's make this good.
Dude, it's on.
Sister Tor. The sister to the brother Tor, who we got in Big Bridge. Tried to run, but the mimic prevented it. Yeah, some of the enemies in this area react to a failed imprisonment attempt by running. And the... what is it? The golden mimic there has the ability no escape, so they can't run. This little lady likes to arm wrestle her brothers, and you'd better believe she holds her own. Has a habit of charging her own reflection. Maybe it's self-loathing, or maybe she just sees red. Seraphine. I'm not certain I... ah, God, I have you. Very good. X potion and a dead end.
Is this? Come on, bring it.
Let's begin.
Okay. Wind, water. Pandasha.
Not done yet.
Okay.
Come on, Popple. Yeah, that can happen when you have counterattacks. Okay, later. Sure, I will need it again, so I'll return quickly and come back.
Let's make this good.
And I got a frog. A toad that favors windy places, but you've already figured that much out, haven't you? These croak and dagger types like to lullaby prey to sleep before they strike. Every Sunday they get together for a cappella practice, for a cappella practice, followed by burgers and french fries. Leave it with Seraphine. And I found another mirage. The Water Golem. Prism Tunity Wars deal a lot of damage at once. An itty bitty golem variant with a surprisingly high threshold for physical pain. Hit it with magic, however. Has a passion for baby spheres, ichthyology, and seafood. Buffy spheres. No. No. Leave it be.
We've got the advantage.
You won't know what hit you.
Okay, this is the group. I got the water golem from one such group. Wind Toad and the Water Stone.
Yeah.
Hmm. Hi, Aethas. Okay, can go further on, or we can take you on.
Come on, bring it.
Let's begin.
The Cruiser Beast. Well,
this is it.
Earth and darkness. And I counter attack. Well, we can try. There's our counter attack. 1900 HP. A formidable foe with large horns that positively crackle with electricity. Thanks to this, it's never had a good headache. Watch out for its powerful strikes and magical counterattack. And I get a clear quest, which is a gimme golem item. One of many. I believe it's a total of 4 we need to access the secret area of this dungeon.
Let's make this good.
Dude, it's on!
A pale berry. I believe you already have a baby pale berry. Ow. Knife? Yeah, knife hurts. When it hits, it doesn't have a good hit rate, but when it hits, it hurts. Light attacks. I don't think I have any on this setup. Oh wait, Lana's holy. I just hope it doesn't kill him. He'll take a shell. Banish? Banish is better. Banish is better. Kill it, please. Finish. Prism.
We did it.
Predictable.
White blight that wields fearsome light magic and an even fearsomer knife. Rumor has it that under the robe is a t-shirt that reads, I'm not pale, I'm pigmentally challenged. Make of it whatever you will. Something? A mega phoenix. Nice find. Come float the eye. float us over there.
Tama, stand by for warp 10.
Roger the Wilco, standing by.
Warp!
Oh, good old warp drive. But let's be realistic. Everyone knows warp 10 is the limit, and we're clearly not moving at infinite speed.
Dude.
Does she know we were the kidding?
You know, Wayne. A remedy plus? Anything else, Tim? No. And let's take the green stone. Safe point. I believe this is a way back to the start. Yeah, this was gray like the red one before and was deactivated. Now we can just get back here quickly. That was especially useful once when you couldn't just change your prism loadout here at save points, only at the gate. Yeah. Switch. What do you need? Wind resistance and weight 9. Let's see, what do you have in wind resistance? Nothing. Less than nothing. Less than nothing, I guess. We have less than nothing, okay.
Yeah, we got this.
I guess we're doing this.
The unicorn. I still have a pale berry prism. Oh, it might be I unlocked the baby pale berry through transfiguration, not through catching it, and I still have a prism from that. That could be.
This is it.
Inflict status ailment. Any status ailment, if death maybe not. Okay, what do we have? Let's see. How about blind? Unicorn is also one of those mirages that tend to flee if you fail to catch it. So again, bring something with no escape if you truly want it. A most legendary beast with a single corner and a horn adorning its forehead, also known as the Spear Horse. Insane, but if you can get close enough, the horn doubles as a code track in an emergency. That's not very nice. Regen, healing horn, enhanced cure, banish. And if you see the abilities on the right side, you can guess what it develops with Gungnir, Zendetskin, and Allah's shield. Yeah, sure. Take the Mirage with you. Wait a minute, can we? Of course that doesn't have... I had hoped it had some wind resistance. But no. Imp go out. Okay, now let's see what we can do regarding wind resistance. Maybe not quite you, but... sort by size, level, weight. We need wind resistance. Aperion. Maybe so let's take Bubbles and what else can we exchange? The kit, maybe something large. Magitek armor P, but that's very boring. I could take Shiva along. Can transfigurate into the other dragons. Do we still not smash at least? Sky Dragon? Yeah, you do. Okay, let's see what this thing does. Blizzaga. Enhanced ice. Ice resistance is always useful. Then it's useless. Sky Dragon. Hyperion. And because... pretty sure that only led to the treasure chest over there. Right, okay. Another Mega Phoenix, and the path is blocked by a rubble. Good, but I think I end the episode here. Next time we continue to climb up the tower and see what else is there. Until then, I'm Mace, and don't get lost.